the last part, we applied the skin modifier and block out the bones. Now I want to write a simple script to easily adjust the vertex weights. By the way, I'm only using MacroScript for this tutorial because of two reasons. One is it's easy to use, and second and real one is Mac does not support Python completely. For example, I can't write this script in Python in a way that you see in a moment. Open new script under the scripting menu. What I want to have is a script tool that can calculate the movement of the mouse as soon as we click and start to drag. We can use the scripted mouse tools. If we check the MaxDev documentation, which you can find in the description, we can see a simple example of a scripted mouse tool. Let's try this one to see how it works. The syntax of a tool in MaxScript is similar to a function definition, but instead of calling it directly, we should write start tool before the name of our tool. Let's run this. Click on the viewport and drag the mouse while holding the left mouse button. That's cool. Okay, now let me read and explain the script to you. Line 1 is the definition of the tool named foo. Line 3, we define a local variable called b to assign our box to it. Line 4 is executing an expression when we start to click on the viewport. Line 5 contains an if statement, which is telling us if our click is equal to 1, then create a box with the position of word point and assign it to the variable b we just made in line 3, and if it's not equal to 1, then stop the tool. Line 6 is responsible for updating the position of the box called b. We realized how it works, but what is this word point in the tool? We are assigning it to the position of our box, so it's a pointer value. If we take a look at the next page of the scripted mouse tools in the documentation, we can find a few other values that we can use in our tool. What I like to use is viewPoint, because it returns a point2 value and it gives me the mouse position at the screen space, so I know that it works in any perspective or orthographics viewport at any angle. Let's start writing. Name it setSkinWeight. Create two local variables, old and sensitivity, and set its value to 0.005. Define mouse point like this. Check if the click value is equal to 1. And if it is equal to 1, then assign the y component of viewpoint to old variable. And then define mouse move. This time check if the click value is equal to 2. And if it is, then calculate the value like this. And start the tool at the end. Now if I run this, we can see a smooth interpolation between two negative and positive values. But we can go more than 1 and less than 0. So we need to clamp this value. Define a local variable named val and assign a test value to it at the first mouse click. Create another variable named newval in the mouse move and change the expression to this. Now we need two if statements. And at the end, print the new val to see if everything is working. Now we need to get the effect of the selected vertices to assign it to our val and then assign our new val back to it. And it's a simple thing to do. We can access the effect of the bone on the selected vertices using this code. Assign the effect of the skin modifier to the val at mouse point click. And then assign our clamped new val to the skin modifier using skin operations like this. Note that you may think it's not working on some vertices, and it's because we cannot assign any number less than 1 to a vertex that is affected by only one bone. Now we have a great tool that we can use to speed up our skinning process, but I don't want to run this tool using a script editor every time. So I will convert it to a macro script like this. You can use your category here and assign a text to button text. Now if I run this, I can access it by searching the macro name. Or even a faster way is assigning a shortcut to it. Now it's your turn to work on your creature. I hope you learned something, and see you in the next part.